So as we are mostly using our eyes to extract information from the world and do things in the world, we are developing algorithms so that computers can also extract similar types of information from the world. In particular, in my group, we really focus on extracting geometric information of the world, combining that with semantic information of the world, and really enable then robots or other devices to have this understanding of the world. It's been interesting. So in the last few years, there's been two major areas in computer vision. One of them is, let's say, geometric computer vision, an area that my group is very much focused on, an area that has, you know, had a lot of progress already for many years, but in the last few years, things have really come together and really robust solutions, really things that work out in the world are being used, and you see results in self-driving cars, in mixed reality, in robotics. An area that was struggling for a long time was more extracting semantic information from images. That has, in the last few years, been revolutionized through deep neural networks, through AI techniques, convolutional neural networks specifically, which work particularly well on image data. And so there's been a ton of progress in that space. And so now we can essentially answer the algorithms coming, bringing those two things together. We can start addressing a lot of real world applications. And what you actually see as a result of that is that industry is really picking up on computer vision. Our conferences have multiplied by a factor of 5 in terms of the mensa that the people that attend it. So there's a huge amount of interest, a huge amount of investment in many different areas because computer vision now actually can solve real world problems. Okay, so HoloLens 2, first, it's a device that's way more comfortable. So essentially, you can just put it on like this. You can actually easily go in and out of an immersive experience. But if we look also, the device is able to understand a lot more of what is going on. So in particular, the depth camera now can be used not only to find, to let you click things in the world, but it actually tracks in detail all your fingers so that you can now very intuitively manipulate digital information, essentially in the same way as you can manipulate real world objects. What you can also see here is two small cameras that look at your eyes. This enables us to both let you to verify your identity, to do biometric authentication and be sure you are the person wearing the device and so give you access to your information. It also allows to track the eyes, which both allows us to optimize the imagery to get the best possible quality imagery to your eyes, but also optimize microphone array so that you can, this is also a perfect device for speech. So if I put on this device here, I have some microphones that get the environment noise, but I also have two microphones very close to my mouth, meaning that even in a loud factory environment, I can just whisper to the device and the device can understand me. But then, of course, one of the key benefits of the new device, of course, that it's more immersive. So the display, the part of the world that gets overlaid with digital information is now much bigger. It's more than twice as big as in the first generation device. And so you get a much more immersive, you get much more natural interaction with the world because much more of the world is augmented now. Well, I think there's two things. One is, I think this device is already ready for large markets, but in a set of specific scenarios. So in scenarios where you put on the device, you do a certain task. When you're done with the task, you put on the device again. That is the current state of this device. As we go forward and we can shrink the device further, make it more immersive, then this device will become just natural to wear all the time. Essentially, if we can get to this form factor, then it's a device that you will wear all the time. At that point, we'll actually forget, as you know, already today, we don't know how we would live without a phone or mobile phones. 5-10 years from now, we'll all be wearing glasses that put information everywhere in front of us in a very intuitive way, and we'll always have access to the relevant information to do whatever we are trying to do. And it will be all very intuitive and very natural, and by then it will be, everyone will naturally have these type of devices. What we're really looking at is going from single-person experience to experiences naturally in the world and all the different, all the people. So we are essentially going towards shared mixed reality experiences. To provide that, it's not anymore a single device experience. It's essentially many devices that are all connected to the cloud where you can then provide these type of experiences. And so in those things, it's the cloud plays a critical role as a combination with the devices. So we have intelligent edge devices, an intelligent cloud, and together they can provide those experiences.